Hello and welcome to the Johnny Danger Show. I'm Johnny Danger, coming live from the Danger Zone. And today we bring you another episode of the Saturday Morning Podcast, where we bring you the latest and greatest in internet news, but we bring it to you today. All right. Nailed it. Another intro in the books. Who says I can't do intros? Oh, wait, I'm supposed to finish it off. And today on the show, we have a great show for you today. We're going to be talking about Dave Porkboy being a piece of shit. The wage gap, maybe. We'll see if we have time. Gary Busey's trending topic. And a bunch of other jokes and goofs and gaffs. Here on the Danger Zone. As you can see, I have my fancy background again, with a little something special in the background, as you can see up here. I'm giving credit, y'all. I'm giving credit. That's right. These backgrounds I do not create. I take them from this website that provides you with free stock footage called pixbay.org or .com. Which I didn't think there was anything wrong with doing a fancy background because it was free. But, you know, not giving credits to the people who took the stock footage is probably wrong. So, from now on, I'm going to see if I can keep a tag on the top right at all times when somebody else's artwork or property is being displayed. That might not include the reactions that I do. That being said, let's get right with it, y'all. Let's go. Yeah, you thought I was going to do the copyright thing, right? All right, let's just get right into it. Yeah, you like that transition, babe? You know, shrimp, 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 shrimp. That's my new thing that I'm doing now. It's shrimp, 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 shrimp. You know, I'm shrimp, 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 shrimp. It has no relevance to anything. But our first topic, let's just get right into it. Dave Porkboy, right? He's been recently going viral, or trending, as they call it, because of his previous videos where he would go up to pizza shop places and
we
review them.
We also have a phone.
And here's going to be an example of when he does it. Right?
Where's the guy, right? So this guy.
I got a lot of
riffraff come up to me. Let me be part of a review. Let me do this. He says something.
All right, maybe we should go to some. Maybe we should explain some of the. Put some context to this. So Dave Porkboy, that's his actual name. He is a content creator who goes to a random pizza shop, takes one bite of the pizza, and then discredits their whole organization. Thank you. He takes one bite of the fucking pizza. How the fuck are you going to determine whether a slice of pizza is good or not by one bite? Last night, my wife ordered the most disgusting pizza, you know, God love her, but the most disgusting pizza I've ever had. But when I took the first bite of the pizza, it was amazing. It was like, oh my God, look at all these flavors. Oh, boom, pow. After the third bite of that pizza, I was sick. I was sick of it. It was disgusting. So how the fuck are you going to determine how good of a pizza is by one bite? So this motherfucker is really, like, literally closing, like, hurting businesses just to become famous. And in this video, he doesn't even, the pizza's not even the main attraction here. So that's the context. So here we go.
That's never been said.
And it also, I know this is off topic, but you guys don't think it's a little weird to be wearing, this guy's from New England, right? And he has a Syracuse jersey and hat. I don't know. Just let's
want to do
go.
A hairline review.
You're doing your pizza review. Can we get a hairline rating?
Hairline rating. What the fuck? Is this
I'll
different?
I'll take my hat off.
What, you got a fucked up hairline or something?
I do.
All right, fine, yeah. I'm expecting one of the worst hairlines I've ever seen from this dude. He's got a hat on. He's like, keep him up.
All right, so I guess if I can add some context to this video, essentially he's trying to do one of his famous one-bite pizza reviews. And then some guy just asks him to review his hairline. Because, you know, It's the same?
I'm 21.
This better be so bad I lose my breath.
Oh my goodness.
It's bad. It's bad. It's bad.
You ever notice like people who have really bad hairlines are usually really good looking people? Like if you cover up the top of his head, you can see, you could tell like he like, let's just look at him with the hat on. Get out of here. You're no longer important here. Get out of here.
He's so bad.
Like he looks like a normal schmo, right? And all of a sudden,
who's my breath?
Who's that character from? Who's that character from American Horror Story? I'm gonna have to look that up. American Horror Story. Bald girl, I guess. Yeah, there she is. Are they gonna give me a name? I mean, I guess I could just show you what I'm looking at. This lady? So, with the hat? Hold on.
Who's got a hat? Better be so bad.
Before the hat? That's him. After the hat? Pow! I think they did a good job making the comparison. Round of applause. Okay, all right, back on topic. Let's go. Dave Pork Boy.
And I lose my breath.
It's bad.
It's bad.
So bad. One out of ten.
It's breathtakingly bad. You're 21?
21.
Is it a disease?
No, I just wear a hat all the time.
It's ugly.
No, I don't think that's accurate. I don't think losing your hair, because I'll tell you why I lost my hair. I stress the fuck out over everything. And so I used to do this, ready? Whenever I was in deep contemplation, self-reflection, whatever you call it, overthinking, I'd overthink like this. And so I'd run my fingers through my hair and then I'd pull a little bit because I don't know why, I like the feeling. Every time I did that, though, I ended up pulling out pieces of hair. Until there was no longer a hairline there, and you can see the widow's peak that was occurring. And then with the last hair that remained, I would do the same. I would just go like that, because I used to love playing with my hair. But I guess I used to play with it too much. I'm just glad I never lost something else. I think, yeah, I'll be here all week. Where's my, hold on, rim shot? Where are you at? There it is. Hey, yeah. I'll be here all week. All right. Dave,
the 9-8 hairline.
9-8 hairline.
Walk around.
All right. Well, that's a terrible.
Be like, boy, I got a hairline for you. What a move. All right.
Funny stuff. Let's go. Round of applause. That's not what we're trying to talk about. We're trying to talk about destroying a whole person's whole business with one bite of a pizza. Here we go. Well, let's take a look at the first time he ruined somebody's business with one bite of pizza. Here we go. Like an igloo. So this is the famous video. Oh, I should be crediting these videos. Play by play reacts.
Ice cold. They gave me an ice cold slice.
Ice cold.
Ice
cold. He took one bite and said it's ice cold. Okay. Question. Because he's reviewing the pizza. He says it's ice cold. Is it good or bad? That's the first question, because you're rating it, right? It's ice cold.
It's cold. Go ice fishing with an igloo on this.
Still no rating. Sir, I'm guessing you hate it. If you hate it, do not take another bite.
This guy's got permission to shoot on my pants.
Oh, he likes it. Because he took a second bite, right? If you hate it, you're not going to take another bite. So, all right, here we go.
Video today?
Uh-uh.
Cool.
So then, obviously, the owner of the establishment hears him talking shit about his pizza, asks him to leave, even though it's not illegal to do that.
I'm going to need you to make your way out this way.
Okay. I'm going to give this a 0.0.
And so after the manager confronted him and his second bite, because it was so bad the first time, he gives it a 0 out of 0. let's see who gets a non-zero out of zero, right? Because obviously maybe it was just that bad, right? First bite was too bad that he had to take a second bite and enjoy the second bite and then gave it a zero out of zero. But here we go. Oh, this is the hairline guy again. All right, here we go.
It's gonna be a monster score, but I'm gonna keep it honest.
All right, here we go.
You also said the Lucali guy said you guys had the best. Oh. Yeah, Mark said best pizza in the world.
All my friends.
So like, I'm sorry, but you could tell like who's gonna get the good review. It's either the manager's like very openly receptive to Dave Portnoy. And then Dave Portnoy is just going to be like, yeah, even if it wasn't that great, he's going to be like, yeah, 6 out of 10. But then if the manager's not okay with him, and you'll see this because I'm going to play you a couple videos, he's going to be like, oh, 0 out of 0. Even though, you know, he kind of seems like he's enjoying the pizza. So this one, right? So he seems to enjoy this pizza, but right. So a lot of the things that I've noticed from watching his videos is that he likes two things. One, a good undercarriage, which you're being biased at that point because not everybody likes the hard undercarriage. And I'm guessing what he means by that is that hard shell underneath that holds the pizza up. He'll criticize if a pizza is like floppy. I don't mind that. I actually like the fact where it's all floppy and you get to like sandwich it a little bit and then you eat it. That's my preference of eating the pizza. I like a soft, chewy crust. Some people might not like that. Oh, give me a second. My nose is acting up here. I had a kill switch button now. This is my be right back screen when I'm live streaming, but I don't do that as often. I only do that once a week. I'm going to be doing 2 times a week because I have an NFL draft now. But I'm just nasal spraying myself so I could talk. And it just looks weird to do on camera, so I did it off camera. There we go. A round of applause for professionalism, baby. Let's go. I'm so glad that we have, like, decent backgrounds again. I just like having a visual background and then, like, something different each week. Can I have that? So he likes a decent undercarriage, and then he loves when the fucking manager, like, interacts with him. Cause that's like, what is there else to talk about pizza? Like, let's put that into perspective, right? Let's say I made a show about rating podcasts, right? Let's just look up a random podcast, even though I'm just going to be taking credit for somebody else's work again. Oh, I know a good podcast. Okay. What is this show? What is this called show? What is the show called? BFFs. Oh, Dave Portnoy's in this. Okay, all right. Let's watch a minute of this podcast, and then let's judge it, right? Technically, it should be 10 seconds, but I want to give him a fair shake. So for the next minute, we're going to react to this podcast. We can't play it because of copyright reasons, but we're going to play, and I'll do my best to react. Ready?
Make sure you guys tap.
This is a podcast that I'm reviewing. This is the BFFs episode 143. Aw, 143. Here we go.
What's up, boys and girls? Welcome to the BFFs YouTube channel. Make sure you guys tap the bell, subscribe, like the video.
I'm not going to do that, but let's go. All right. Good energy right off the bat. Good all graphics. Right. Let's go.
BFFs, 3 different locations. I don't like his voice. Brought to you by Raising Cane's, and finally we get the Raising Cane's.
I don't like how he's like really
in the office. I'm starving while we're waiting. I already have.
He's starting off with a complaint. I don't like that.
You ate Cane's?
Yeah, it's here. They brought it in. They got the Times Square location.
He's talking about a restaurant.
Multiple of these.
There's a lady speaking now.
I feel like Austin keeps promising me.
There's a guy now talking. I don't know who he is.
And then I never do. So I don't know what's up with that.
Where's the closest LA location?
They're talking about a restaurant. Is this show about restaurants? What's his address? It's titled Is Bree and Zach Bryan's new album. Oh, they're talking about albums.
Oh, it's the best. That's why I was looking.
Okay.
But whatever. Austin baited me. It's fine.
Okay.
Sorry, there's a dog.
Here, I'll show a little bit.
I thought you were doing
pinky doll for a second. I had my head down. I thought I was hearing like,
oh, that's pinky a doll stuff. Pinky doll reference. I like that.
We all like Raising Cane's best time of the year for a tailgate.
All right, that's a minute. We'll stop right there. Let round of applause for that podcast, random podcast that I just chose out of nowhere. Overall, I didn't really like what they were talking about. I didn't think it was very interesting. I didn't really find it much engaging. I couldn't relate to anything that was happening. I'm going to give that a 2 out of 3. I mean, 2 out of 10. Round of applause for that. See? There's an hour worth of that fucking podcast. How the fuck were you able to make a decision on a fucking podcast? All right, let's play a minute on another podcast. Just a random one that I've never heard of or maybe acknowledged in the past. Here we go. Random podcast. Bingo bango bongo. This seems promising.
We can't see. Never forget. Our special.
Okay, this is the H3 podcast. Everything. They're talking about something. Seems pretty serious, but we can start a minute from here. Here we go.
About Shredder, I feel like it's so much like just
Shredder. Out. That's relatable. And, like, I've seen the Ninja Turtles, so I really, like that.
As much as we talk about it, I feel like you can't really like get other people to understand. Mm. It's such a personal experience.
Yeah, I can relate to this.
This kind of gives me comfort, and like, it's not gonna get lost.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. So far, this is very heartwarming, very engaging. I can feel what these people are going to. I'm gonna give them like a 9.1 out of 10. Round of applause. I don't know who they were. So that's the equivalent, right? Because like you're literally dismantling somebody's whole organization, whether you like the manager or not, because. The only people going viral is the people who have an issue with Dave Portnoy doing their interview and, you know, losing their business. And I guess the latest victim, there's like, I had leftover pizza this morning, actually. It's just kind of funny, but there's crumbs all over the freaking table and it's itchy. And I guess the recent video that's going viral now, recent... If I can find it, if I'm organized enough. Is this one? No. Let's go. I don't know. We might have to move on from this topic. Oh, here's another one. So he goes to this place. And then they literally, like, have his picture on the restaurant, so they like they're expecting him, so yeah, of course, lick his ball sack, his from under cheese, and then yeah, then let's see how good he rates his score. In fact, let's just go to the end and find out what his score is.
The top of my mouth gone, won't be back for a week and a half. Got to focus at all times. I didn't, and I paid the price. Clean cut, 7-8. Put my head on the pillow.
7-8. That's pretty high, I think. He was complaining, right? The ice cold one, right? Didn't cause you any harm. The hot one burnt the roof of your mouth. But the restaurant owner was more receptive to you, so they get a 7 out of 10. All right, round of applause for Dave Portnoy.
Rest easy. I think it's the perfect score for this pie.
7 out of 10, round of applause. And you know, and he never, even if he likes the pizza, because when I've noticed, like, the pizzas that he does like are like these generic, basic. I mean, it's pizza. Like, what are you gonna fucking do with pizza? Domino's. I make my Domino's pizzas with Alfredo sauce, so, and ranch sauce, so you already know. But, like, I mean, like, let's be honest. All the pizza slices that he's getting is just cheese, random cheese pizza. There was, like, this one video where he got, like, $1,000 pizza and he dismantled it. But, hey, if you can afford it, go right ahead. But don't fucking go after, like, the little guy just trying to sell pizzas to make a fucking living. All right, pivoting now. This scared the ever-living shit out of me. Maybe we should change music here. So China showed us a couple weeks ago this. Look at that. Holy crap. This seems like it could be a bomb. What is this? Can anybody explain what this is? This gotta be at Ocean Gate. I love comment sections, bro. The brand new Dyson vacuum, yo. Ocean Gate Titan V2. Ocean Gate is back, baby. Real flux capacitor. Ocean Gate 2.0. The flux capacitor. It's a flux capacitor. Bro, I'm thinking this is a bomb of some sort. I don't... maybe we should look it up. Yeah, let's do that. Let's be informed. Let's be an informed podcast today. Video of giant bomb in China? I don't know. How do you search for that? China don't care. That's not even viral. TikTok. Oh, they're not showing it. What is this? How do you even search for this? Giant bomb looking Pokemon dressed to fill autofill in TikTok. Giant bomb. Nope. Guys, this is a bleeding edge podcast. I promise you. Maybe let's just move on. What else do I got? Oh, the wage gap. I guess we could talk about the wage gap. Nah, we don't have enough video footage for that yet. Oh my goodness. This podcast is going great today. All right, let's focus. Like, there's three videos, there's three episodes that I'm planning. One's gonna be a 4-hour video regarding the dating scene and everything that everybody has to talk about regarding that. I don't know why I can't stand this lady. I've seen this lady on TikTok, and this is her reacting to somebody making fun of her. But good lord, she's completely on point. So I guess out of context, this is the Lady J. You can find her at This Is The Lady J. And she posts these reaction videos where she just like stands there or sits there in front of the camera, and then she starts to make her assessment of whatever she's looking at. And my biggest problem with her is just the way she composes herself is just, I don't know, it's just so pedantic or condescending. But here we go. Okay. So this is what this lady thinks about her.
Okay, I've got my wall of pictures to look at. Oh, hang on. One more thing. I don't have the required...
Oh, I should tell you who it is. This is the person that she's tagging. She didn't even tag her in that video. She completely took her out. I bet. That's how you know she was offended by this.
Weird candy, but I have this. I hope this does. It's the best I got. Oh, wait. I forgot one more thing. Hang on. Okay.
Because you could tell that... So she always wears her tank tops. So right off the bat. Oh, I don't have a tank top, but I have this. So hopefully this is okay. Not amused. Not amused. You can tell. She's just silently watching.
Oh, I think I'm ready. I think I'm ready.
All right, here we go.
Cool.
Oh,
we good?
The little cummerbund. Okay, let's go.
Okay. I have noticed that white women that speak with a complete lack of inflection and a forced condescending tone, reinforced by their lack of facial expression due to the overuse of Botox and fillers.
Is that accurate? I don't think she has Botox. That's probably why she laughed. She's like, she was dead serious up until the Botox thing, because it's like, if you ever go after somebody who's a bullshit artist and you're calling all their bullshit, this is the face they're going to be making until you say something that's not factually accurate, and then they can laugh at themselves to go, I don't have that, I don't do that
expression due to the overuse of Botox and fillers.
And she even puts a little caption, I've never had any cosmetic procedure in my life. And she's, well, what about the rest of this condescending stuff, standing behind your your plaques right there to so you could seem like you're smarter and your condescending voice. Why didn't you say anything about that?
Absolutely nothing to add to the conversation other than their own pontificating as they ask for explanations they have no desire in hearing. Did I nail it? Did I get it?
Round of applause. Okay, guys. Let's go.
Yay! Okay, y'all go have a day.
Round of applause.
Anyway, bye.
Let's go. So, all right. So, if you're not familiar with this lady, Jay, let's just go. Let's just to give her a fair chance. Let's hear one of her takes. I'm just gonna grab something randomly.
Whenever I see a comment like this, I always stop and. Whenever I see a comment like this, I always stop and ask myself a couple of questions. The first question being, has the definition of the word slur recently changed? Has it been altered in some way, which would make that statement, in fact, true? So, I do my due diligence and go look up what the definition of the word slur actually is. And I find that the definition has not changed. It still means exactly what it has always meant. So, then I ask myself another question. Were they possibly misunderstanding what the word slur meant? This is entirely possible, because there are words that specifically describe a particular demographic of people based on their skin tone that are absolutely disparaging and fit every single definition as is outlined above. So please, tell me why there are no supposed slurs
what?
Towards white people.
Yeah, round of applause.
Whenever I see a comment like this, I always
what'd she say?
Ask myself a couple of questions.
Yeah, yeah. Shut up. Shut up. Just shut up. Like, what the fuck? What does slur even mean? So that's a Lady J, ladies and gentlemen. Round of applause. Cause I just fucking can't, man. Cause you know everybody got their opinions, but good lord, are the people with bad with poor opinions have the most clout? I'm out here making point after point, and no one's out here watching me. Are you kidding me? ChatGPT, where are you? Hi, it's B. I named my... Oh, is B underscore here? B, Beatrix. Beatrix, hello. How to do? Round of applause for Beatrix. That's so random. I put my ChatGPT bot, and it just said hello to B. It's more engaging than I am. Actually, but no, we did get ChatGPT back. I found a tag. So a round of applause for that. Whoops. Alright, alright. Back to the show. Here we go. Beatrix Kiddo. I wanted to talk about Bradley Cooper. No, Brentley Cooper. I don't know her name. But she's becoming a better person lately, so I can't really talk about her. I wanted... there's so much stuff I want to talk about. I just can't. I don't think I have enough information to provide in order to back anything else up. Oh, apparently China's living in the future. Here we go. For some reason, they're about that life. So this is somewhere in Asia. I don't have time to backdate anything, but they have drones firefighting at this point. We're still out here on a fucking ladder, on a 40-foot ladder, fighting fire, getting people injured. China, Japan, or Asia. Look at that. Round of applause for everybody doing better than us. Am I right, everybody? Man, the bot loves me. Yeah. Unlike the host of the show, apparently the host of the show don't give a shit about his viewers. What do the audience think about that? Hey, hey.
Boobies.
Hey, don't say that. All right. I guess that's all right. I guess I deserve that. But, yeah, so that's that. But look at this. Oh man, I didn't put all the videos next to each other. Bro, this is such a well-performed podcast. I don't even know where I put it. Okay, here's a flying car. Like, this is the reality that I thought we were gonna have.
The world's first electric flying car has been approved for test flights and is even available for pre-order for the price of $300,000. California's Olive Aeronautics has received a special airworthiness certification from the Federal Aviation Administration to test its Model A flying car on both the road and in the air. Last year, the startup automaker opened pre-sales for what it says is, quote, the only drivable flying car with vertical takeoff and landing capabilities.
This is crazy, by the way. I just want to toss this out there. It's a fucking flying car.
The Olive Model A flying car is designed to fit within existing urban infrastructure.
Like, imagine that. Like, say, imagine you're stuck in traffic and you're like, no. Here, I'll show you what that looks like. Oh. Oh, man. I really don't like this traffic. I got this. Boop. Man, round of applause for me. I'm fucking comedy gold. All right. Back to flying cars.
It can be driven on public roads and fit into a standard garage. The two-person vehicle is fully electric with a driving range of 200
fully
miles.
Fully electric. Imagine being in the air and that goes out of
miles.
Buyers
can power. Pay a $150
deposit. You just like literally have cars flying, falling down out of the sky. Some like some billionaire somewhere, you know for a fact, is getting roadhead or flyhead, whatever you would want to call it. He's just up there like, battery low, battery low. Okay, maybe not a funny joke. All right, next topic.
Deposit to join the general queue.
Why I gotta ruin everything? You know what it is? It's that goddamn Obama. Just kidding. We love Obama. All right. What else does every other country have that we don't? Let's find out. I had a whole thing of this. I don't know why I can't find it anywhere now.
Dude, I fucking hate.
Yo, bro, I can't. Why am I so unorganized? Oh, does everybody want to look at this baby crocodile? Look at this! Look at this! Why? Why? Where did it go? Why? How? That is so fucking cute. Is there any music? Yeah, there it is. Oh my god! It's so squishy! What's that from the movie Monsters? It's so fluffy, I wanna die! That would have been a nice sound bite. It's so fluffy, I want to die! But luckily...
He's so fluffy, I'm gonna die!
There it is. Round of applause. We nailed that. Alright, here we go. What movie is that from, anyways? What is this? Oh, it's from it's from that Mini-Me movie. No. Why can't I show it? Despicable Me. There you go. All right, what else we got? Alright. I don't like this guy. For some reason, I don't like this guy, and I don't want him speaking for me. So he talks about how he doesn't like people saying Hispanic or something like that. And he doesn't like people calling him Latino. And as a Latino man, I guess I have a right to have an opinion on this. Music's really loud. All right, so here we go. Ricardo Ignacio, 916.
Identifying myself as Latino, there's two huge problems. Number one is the fact that...
Oh, boy, here we go. Everyone got an opinion. Here we go. You know what they say? Opinions are like elbows, and all of them stink. Yeah. I can't. I can't do this show anymore, man. It's messing with my psyche.
Latin terminology obviously is a terminology that belongs to Europeans. That itself, it's already a fact. But number two.
All right. So just, I should be offended because Europeans made it up. Okay, let's go.
Even if I were to use the Latino term to umbrella people like me, the problem with that is that the Caucasian, the European descent born in Latin American countries also identify as Latino. They are completely European, meaning white. So why would I make the mistake of identifying with the same umbrella as Caucasian if we do not have the same struggle? What is our similarity? That we speak Spanish? That means nothing. We're not the same people. You are Caucasian. I am Native American. How could we umbrella ourselves under the same thing? Impossible, because the problem and the damages that causes is this. When a white person that identifies as Latino is some sort of public figure and or celebrity, and they are a spokesman of the Latino community, they are speaking on behalf of their white people that identify as Latino.
All right, yeah, we're done. Yeah. Oh, bummer. What is it? What's your problem? Do you have a problem with vocabulary? Just take it up with Webster's, I guess. They make up words. We don't, apparently. Maybe we should have came up with the word.
About me, they're not talking about the struggle of indigenous people of Mexico, Central and South America. Absolutely not. They're talking and they're representing their.
All right, we're done. You're done. That's why I didn't play this video for such a long time. I'm like, I have an opinion on this, but this is so boring. I can't even bring myself to talking about it. Are guns okay? What did I? Oh, they took this down. Okay. I guess they're not okay. This says fuck around and find out. What is this about? Oh God, I can't.
You're feeding a bear.
You're feeding a bear. That's literally the one thing they tell you not to do.
Feeding wildlife.
Yeah, because I mean, if you're tossing bread to a pigeon, that's one thing. I mean, I guess it's a black bear, so that might be okay. You know what this shows you? It just shows you, right? And so that bear, next time that there's people around, he's gonna come up expecting food. And what if they don't have food? What if they encounter a kid? And the kid's just like, oh, a big dog. I can't. Round of applause. This show is literally killing me. Slowly. You're done. I can't. Beatrix. What is happening? What is this? I remember this went viral. I can't. This is actually really funny. Hopefully this is the reaction. Ready?
So that's really just it then, Gary? You're just gonna walk away from everything we built together. You're the one who decided to walk away from us so you can lay down with another man, Sarah. That's not the point, Gary. I made a mistake. That doesn't mean you can just leave and tear our family apart like this. You won't even try to make this work. Oh, don't you even dare try that shit on me. I tried to make this work. The first time you cheated on me, Sarah, I stayed. I stayed right here and I stayed faithful. You fucking know that. We went to counseling. I thought we could move past it. I did everything I could to keep this family together. You still threw it all away.
I'm like so invested in this story.
You expect me to stay with someone who has sex with my own brother while I'm at work? I'm not saying I expect you to stay. I'm saying you would stay if you really loved me, Gary. If you really loved me, you wouldn't have put me through what you put me through. If you really loved the kids, you wouldn't be putting them through what you're putting them through right now. Mm-hmm. You're the one who's putting them through this.
You tell him, Gary.
I know I'm a good father to those girls. Yeah. Nothing's ever going to change that. But that doesn't mean I have to spend the rest of my life with someone like you. Our children are not pawns in your little game of chess, Sarah.
Get him, Gary.
I'm sick of you using them to manipulate me. Well, you know what? Fine then, asshole. You want to leave? Leave! Get out of here! I'm
the one
for this house. Everything in it. I'll come and go as I goddamn please. Anna Lynn isn't even your child. I cheated on you the same time I got pregnant. You listen here, you conniving fucking monster. You can take everything I have. You can play me for a fool as many times as you can get away with. But don't you ever in your fucking life look at me and tell me that's not my fucking daughter. I've raised that little girl since she was the size of my palm. I am her father and I always will be her father no matter what. You know that little girl looks nothing like you. I've known that since the moment she came out, but I've loved her all the same because she still deserves a father. And Lord knows the men.
Oh my goodness. Round of applause for that. Holy shit. That video was brought to you in part by Bellatown. Bellatown is a TikTok creator. I guess this is what they do. That's just what, that one video, though. Just hit a little too close to home. So I guess that's their skit now, or was it their skit from the beginning? No, that was their skit from the beginning. And then so this is the one that got them 15 million views. Good Lord, playing with dolls on the internet got him 2.6 million views. Wait right here. Johnny Danger announces to you its first episode ever of Infinity War. Ant-Man, we need your help. I don't know if I could can Steve Rogers. I'm a hardened criminal right now. Yes, but we need to fight, and we need to fight now. However, John doesn't have many of these pop figures, so we're gonna have to fight each other. I agree, Captain America, for the fate of the world. For the fate of the world. Are y'all gonna die? Yeah, yes. The close-up. Now, after that fight, Ant-Man, will you help me save the world? Let's do this. Up and away! Yeah, and we did it. That was intense. Okay, next on the news. This guy thinks it's I'm going nuts, man. Oh god. Most of my videos are all... What the fuck is this? Say what? Man robs... Oh god, this is interesting. So like when people say girls are only attracted to fuckboys, this is what they mean. Ready for this article?
She was the victim of a robbery. The suspect is accused of taking $100 from her after then, strangely, asking her on out on a date. Amber
yes.
Buron says that she was getting mail from her mailbox when a man walked up to her and showed her that he had a gun in his pocket. She emptied her purse, and as she took the money out, she says he asked her to friend him on Facebook.
I thought maybe if I added him on Facebook...
Well, just pause that for a second. During the robbery, he attempted to riz her up, and you're like, well, John, of course she's going to just use that in order to call the police and get him arrested. You would think. But let's find out how this tale ends.
That would be it, and he'd leave, and he did. But then he continued to message me on Facebook.
Now, police tracked the man down.
Oh, they did. Okay, I was about to say.
Saying that he wanted to pay her back and asking if she wanted to go out on a date with him sometime.
So
the
I
man
did.
Is now charged with armed robbery.
Watch.
They go out next week. All right. Maybe I thought that they ended up together. So.
Breaking news on YouTube.
I wonder if they did go out afterwards. I would love to find that out. That's like the fastest time. The fastest time it took for me to look stupid. I bet you they ended up together, didn't they? All right, she called the police. Oh. What is this? Bangkok Airport.
Dude,
it's like I leave myself like little notes, messages for myself from the past. John, this would be interesting to watch later. And then I watch it later and I go, this is stupid.
That are waiting to board international flights. It's an absurdity. It is crazy. Like, half of the couples in this airport right now are beautiful Thai women with super basic white dudes.
Yeah, like, well, why does that bother you so much? These beautiful women are with these normal looking guys. Yeah, well, yeah, like, what's your problem? Okay. How dare you be happy? Be miserable because you're average looking. Thank you. How dare someone with average looks who doesn't prioritize their looks above everything be happy in a relationship? No, because you know, like, they're most likely taking advantage of the guy, the girl, or no, the guy. They're probably taking advantage of each other. Like, who cares? I don't know. Beatrix, I'm doing better at responding to text messages, right? Not text messages. I'm gonna be miserable now. Yeah, that's right. How dare you? Stop it, B. You're a very lovely woman. Let's listen to this later. Oh, actually, I need to watch this video. 7 streamer tips that 7 must have tools for streamers. Oh, yeah. 7. Tell me how to get more viewers. Should we do the segment on Brentley Cooper? What's this? When you have it enough. Oh, yeah. No, we're not going to watch that. Watch Logan Paul. No, that's stupid. That's boring. Wow, did we go through all of our videos today? How to stop school shootings? See, that's why I can't have a fucking podcast, because I want to just talk about all the stupid... Like, it's not stupid. It's stuff that we need to be talking about, but I just want to talk about it, and that's all I want to talk about. Here, we're going to talk about how expensive it is to...
So, I had a baby 2 months ago.
To have a baby in America. Here we go. So, this is a video from Maxim Body Official. Maxim Batty official is this gentleman, I think. I'm pretty sure, yeah. It's this gentleman who reacts to videos.
So I had a baby.
But this in particular video he reacted to is by Sarai Jones. Actually, why don't we just watch that video, right?
So I had a baby 2 months ago, and here I just got the hospital bill.
Yeah, that's even the baby's having a hard time processing that.
So I vaginally delivered him, and I...
You didn't need to say that. How else would you... Okay, go ahead.
...was induced. And yes, I got the epidural. Whoo, amazing.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. First thing is the labor room / delivery room. 13,000...
So, Beatrix, in case you ever decided to come to America, this is a cautionary tale.
$1,900.
Wait, hold on.
My gosh. First thing is the labor room / delivery room.
So the delivery room is right off the bat is $900. So that's the price of like a studio for a month, right? But that's going to be for a day.
$13,900. Ouch. I got another bill that says room and board semi-private. That was $19,111.
What?
Next charge is anesthesia, $2,181. Pharmacy, $1,200.
Whoa. Hold on, what? Anesthesia is $1,000? I mean, I guess. Because they have to administer it, maybe.
33 cents. Other diagnostic services, that was $1,001. What is that? Please explain. The laboratory
other diagnostic services. It's just other things.
$62. And then
they literally just charged her for air.
I got a charge for the emergency room, which was $411.
So they charged her for the room and then the emergency room.
Those together, $38,757.33. That hurt more than the contractions.
Got them.
Thank God for insurance. They covered a lot of it. My amount due is only $1,418.26.
Okay. Which that's what probably should have been what you paid for. $1,418 is probably what you should have owed after labor. Let's be honest. Because people have been doing labor since the beginning of time and in caves. So you can literally have a baby for free. And I'm not saying you should. You should not have a baby in a dumpster. But you can literally have a baby in a dumpster for free. When the baby was breathing, you have to pay for the air wasted. yeah, because the baby's breathing really quickly. The other patients need that air. Come on, people. B's like, maybe being a surgeon in America might be okay. Yeah, no, seriously, yeah.
I'm not done. I have like three more charges.
Okay. All right, sorry.
Next bill is from U.S. Anesthesia, and they charged me $13.56.68. But after insurance, that was only $135.67. My last two charges is vaginal delivery postpartum.
Stop saying that.
$6,793. Oh, the last final charge was the cervical dilator, which is the balloon that they put up there to induce my labor. Ooh. That was $385. After insurance, $6.51.16. We love insurance. Okay, want to know the final total? In total, it cost me $47,292.01 to have a baby. But after insurance, I had to pay $2,205.
Me and the sound effects.
Wow, thank you. So yeah. I had a baby 2 months ago.
So round of applause for our medical system. Price gouging, now legal in America. All right. So there you have it. And then they blame us for wanting medical care. This is something I notice people doing. So there's people. There's people who are like really crafty at engineering. And then like they do this. So he modified his steering wheel to be able to use his PlayStation controller. Not the joysticks, the actual controller as the wheel. Here, maybe you should listen to the music because it actually embodies what he's doing.
Adapted a
without you, from talking this out my lifestyle. I gotta tell them too late, I don't even know if you're coming down the beginning.
Yeah. Round of applause for that one. Which is, it's cool, right? Because it's like, wow, how the fuck do you do that? But at the same time, I don't want to be anywhere around him when he, this motherfucker thinks he, it's okay to make a quick turn. And then he, like, slams into, like, a group of freaking nuns or something. I don't know. You know how nuns travel in packs. We all know that. That's a common thing. How never to have kids, yeah. I mean, seriously, it's expensive before you have the kid and after you have the kid. There's no incentive to have kids anymore. You'd be broke for the rest of your life. Not really. There's people with kids who do well. There's tax breaks as well, but still. All right, what else do we got on the agenda? How much time have we been streaming for? All right, we're reaching that 1 hour mark, ladies and gentlemen. Should we do some bread pill stuff? Because they're usually a gold mine. All right, no, we're going to hit this. We're going to get demonetized the last 2 minutes. So there's this one video of a girl finessing her dad. The only way, the easiest way to finesse a person my age. Ready? So she's young. And her dad's like around my age. She's probably a little younger, older. But this is her rizzing her father. Rizzing is a term I think that the young kids use to in order to define manipulating, I guess. I don't know, but here we go. So she starts off the video. We already know your game. Gen X likes being around their Gen Z kids. We let you play your little game, even let you think it was your idea. So that's what one of her comments said to her. And then this is what the video that she makes, proving that no, she has the upper hand with her father always.
Watch how soft these Gen X dads are.
Right off the bat. So right off the bat, she comes in. She's playing that song through his radio. She might like that song. There's a strong possibility, but there's an even stronger possibility that he loves that song. In fact, he comes into the car singing it. So right off the bat, not looking great.
Sometimes I feel like,
and then she starts to sing too.
Hey dad.
Okay. Oh, well, he's already in a good mood. So hey dad. Hey dad, what?
Do you think we can pick up my friend?
Oh, pick up her friend? Well, that wasn't on the agenda. All right, well, let's see if he's a pushover. Is he going to say yes immediately?
I don't know. Maybe. Yeah.
Well, it's a maybe. All right. So he didn't fully push over, but let's see. Maybe there's more to this.
You want to do Wonderwall?
Well, I mean, I wouldn't say no.
Did she just say Wonderwall? Did she just say Wonderwall? Excuse me. Today's gonna be the day that we're gonna throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you got to do. I don't believe that. Okay, back to the video.
I wouldn't say no to a little Wonderwall.
Today's gonna be the day that we're gonna.
It's so good.
Yeah.
You have great taste in music.
Yes, she does, doesn't she? Huh?
You were raised right.
Ah, oh, yeah, definitely.
You done
raised
got
right.
Raised right.
Okay?
I'm just saying, like. Yes.
Also known as a buster. Always
talk about what he wants.
Oh, wait. We should get snacks.
Do you notice that the friend is there in the car already? Yeah, the friend's there already.
Snacks, yeah.
Oh, maybe we should get some snacks, Dad. Dad, should we get the snacks? What do you think, Dad? Should we get the snacks?
Please, come on. Please, Dad.
Okay. All right.
Because we are living in a material world. And I'm living in a material world. The donkey laugh was on the whole time. All right, so there you have it. We are not pushovers. Yeah, we can manipulate our parents. Okay, let's carry. So there you have it. I love that video. I just found it this morning, actually. I'm like, we're definitely talking about this. Decay, living in a material world, and I am. You want to get go get snacks, Dad? Yeah, snacks. I mean, we were only just supposed to go get some bread. Now your best friend's in the back seat, and we're gonna go get snacks. Okay. Okay, what else we got? Fucking Dave Portnoy. Stupid ass idiot. I'm tearing up. I love doing the show. I'm not gonna lie, I love doing the show. It's just coming up the topics. Like, I have the three topics that I want to talk about, but I was just so scared to talk about them. Cause I'm living in a material world, and I'm just a terrible girl. What is this?
You complain that your wife never wants to be intimate, but you slap her butt when she's emptying the dishwasher and grope her body.
Okay, it's like 3 o'clock in the morning and I'm up scrolling on TikTok because I can't sleep. And
okay, I'm tired of this music, by the way. Let's switch that up.
Stitched a couple of your videos, so every now and again I see you on my FYP. Women like you and women that think like you are the reason why men don't want to get married anymore.
Okay, I don't know what they're talking about. We'll address that later. All right, I think we're out of time. Yeah, I think we're going to watch one more video and then we're going to call it. We do have a show tomorrow. It's going to be about fantasy football. So if you're a football fan, I know out there in Greece, you guys love football. I know that. So definitely tune in tomorrow. We're going to be talking about T. Higgins, Brock Purdy. I know you know those names. Amon-Ra St. Brown. Over 1,000 yards rushing, Christian McCaffrey, right? Tune in. No, but yeah, we're going to be doing a fantasy football thing on Sundays. I'm going to be streaming that on the sports topic on Twitch. So who knows? I was doing a digital football league that people were kind of joining in. So on Twitter, I think, when Twitter was before Twitter was X. So anyways, on that note, thanks for watching. If you have been watching, I don't think I have any more videos to show. We can't talk about the Pinky Doll stuff anymore because that's old. The Jake Paul, like everything I hold on to for such a long time is old, and like I don't want to talk about it anymore. All right, that's gonna call it. Song's ended. We ended. Thanks for watching. If you have been watching, as always, peace. Oh no, I'm not supposed to be using that background yet until I can find the tag. There it is.